Good morning.
Good morning.
Those acolytes make me be exhausted behind them. They just walk ahead of me really fast. I used to be like a one step at a time. No, they just run faster. My name is Javier Rios, and you can call me as you can. Back in Yale Center, when it was my first Sunday, I present myself, I introduce myself and my lovely wife, which is Mary Swan. Would you stand, please? And she's my lovely wife. And a couple of my parishioners have a problem saying my name. One of them, after a couple of times trying to pronounce my name, he says, "I will call you preacher. I can just..." And he called me preacher for 4 years. And the other one I can recall, he says, "I will call you Harvey. It'll be more easier for me to say Harvey than Javier." And then, so I'm really grateful to be here this morning with you. And if you do not understand what I'm saying, just raise your hand and I will repeat myself, okay? But let me tell you, I will appreciate this church is beautiful, is comfortable enough to feel in family, so let's just come forward. I will not bite you guys, I promise that. Okay? So welcome this morning. Just one announcement, if somebody else has some, but next Saturday we will have the Zimmerman funeral at 1 o'clock. You are welcome to attend. And after, it won't be a meal, but it will be some cookies and refreshments for you to join the family in this hard process. All right, do we have any other announcement?
We do need cookies for Saturday, so if anybody is willing to provide some, just let me know. And if you could have them here Saturday morning, that would be fine.
And also, as is my first Sunday here with you, please excuse all my errors. It can be messy because I really don't know exactly how to work with you. But just give me my time, okay? I will learn your names. I will learn how to work with you. I didn't greet you this morning, but welcome. Thank you for being here with us, guys, this morning. So would you stand, please, and join me? Are we going to have Althea a prelude again? Are we going to have a prelude again, or just, no? Okay, all right. Join me, please, in the opening prayer. Lord, as we walk through the doors of this place of worship, we brought us cares and concerns, our joys and our sorrows. Touch our hearts and heals us. Lord, makes us ready to become your faithful disciples. Amen. Gathering him, faith of our fathers, and the hymnal books will be 7:10.
Thank you.
welcome to worship today. Even when things get hectic, always know that you will find welcome there, here. Come, let us worship the God who always welcomes us. Let us open our hearts to Christ, who welcomes friend and stranger alike. Amen. Please be seated. And we have the time for our children here up front. All right, I will do the candy thing.
Okay,
I'm not a candy man, but would you like some? Oh, till the end. Okay, you get one, and you get one once finished again. Okay.
Okay, am I on?
Yes.
Okay, I want you to look at this picture. Brooke, can you tell me one thing that you see in this picture that's different? Would you be afraid to stand by a lion? I think I would be afraid to stand by a lion. What do you think, Madison, about wolves and lambs and cows together? Would your daddy be happy to have a wolf in the pasture? No. And what about you, Wyatt? Do you see anything that doesn't look right or that's different? A lot of things. One thing is everything has a smile on its face. Do we always have smiles on our faces? No. Sometimes we're a bit sad and unhappy about the way things are going. But Isaiah gave us a scripture that said at some point in time we will all live in peace. The cows will be able to live with the wolves, the sheep and the goats will be able to live with the leopards, and we will all bring peace because the peace will be led by children. Do you think that you will be able to bring peace to this world? What are some things that you might do to make school be a happier, more peaceful place? Be kind. What else? And what?
No bullying.
No bullying? Do you need to cooperate with other people? And what about, is it important that you have a smile on your face when you go to school? Yes, and it's even important that you put a smile on your face when you're with your mom and dad and your family and your brothers and sisters, and everybody can be peaceful. Is that right? Brooke, do you think that's a good thing? I think you do. Okay, so as you go through this week, I want you to be thinking about what you can do to make this world be more peaceable for everybody. So can you fold your hands and we'll say a prayer together? Dear God, I am so thankful for the blessings in my life. Help me to always have a grateful heart and to take time to see blessings around me. Grateful heart and to take time to see blessings around me. Help me to be a blessing to others.
Help me to be a blessing to others.
And to help us to create a world of peace. Amen. Thank you.
And now we do have some treats for you. As you will learn, we're all on a challenging course this morning, and I'm not the best coordinator of this. But the scripture from the Old Testament this morning is the branch from Jesse. A shoot will come up from the stump of Jesse. From the roots, a branch will bear fruit. The Spirit of the Lord will rest on him. The Spirit of wisdom and of understanding, the Spirit of counsel and of might, the Spirit of the knowledge and fear of the Lord. And he will delight in the fear of the Lord. He will not judge by what we see with his eyes, or decide by what he hears with his ears. But with righteousness, he will judge the needy. With justice, he will give the decisions for the poor of the earth. He will strike the earth with the rod of the mouth. With the breath of his lips, he will slay the wicked. Righteousness will be his belt, and faithfulness the sash around his waist. The wolf will live with the lamb. The leopard will lie down with the goat. The calf and the lion and the yearling will lie together, and a little child will lead them. The cow will feed the bear. The young will lie down together, and the lion will eat straw like the ox. The infant will play near the cobra's den, and the young child will put his hand into the viper's nest. They will neither harm nor destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be filled with the knowledge of the Lord, and the waters cover the sea. In that day, the root of Jesse will stand as a banner for the peoples. The nations will rally to him, and his resting place will be glorious. That's from Isaiah. And now from Matthew. In those days, John the Baptist came preaching in the wilderness of Judea and saying, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven has come near." This is he who has spoken through the prophet Isaiah. A voice of one calling in the wilderness, "Prepare the way for the Lord, make straight paths for him." John's clothes were made of camel's hair, and he had a leather belt around his waist. His food was locusts and wild honey. People went out to him from Jerusalem and all of Judea and the whole region of the Jordan. Confessing their sins, they were baptized by him in the Jordan River.
I am not a good singer, so I will ask you, please join me and stand up and let's sing Trust and Obey 467 on your hymnal books.
Thank you.
Please be seated. Now this is the time for bigger, for older children, okay? We're really happy and excited to be with you here this morning after all this summer. We have been out of the church for 3 months. We took sabbatical time for 3 months since April, so April, May, and June was time that not preaching, not relating with the church, just enjoying ourselves. But the last 2 weeks has been really rough time for me and my wife, arriving here, unpacking, settle the house, and get ready for you this morning. So if you see me I'm getting sleep, yes, I am. It's been really busy time unpacking, and this is a huge parsonage to fill, guys. Were you thinking something smaller and just one? I mean, my knees complain a lot. And I am the only one who goes from the top to the very bottom on the basement. So walking those stairs made me feel better on my knees, or maybe feel worse. So think about it for a little bit. So thank you for being here this morning. I'm really grateful that you have a small clock back there. It is out of my sight, so I will have no awareness of the time. So I got to one church, and I said, I will preach for, I have no time to stop preaching. So enjoy the sermon. And then the SPRC chairman came after the service and said to me, Pastor, you can preach all you want, but I have to tell you that we leave the sanctuary at noon. So take your time. Let's talk a little bit about journey. I heard that some family, Bradley family, is in a travel abroad somewhere in Europe, right? When was the last time you were in a journey? You were in a travel. When was the last time that you took time traveling? Don't you remember? When was the last time? A short time. To Denver, maybe. No one? No one has been in a travel a long time? Okay, I challenge you. My wife and I last weekend took the challenge to go to Denver and get to know the city, and we get lost and we get hungry and we were late and we were hot, but at the end we enjoyed it. So every journey, every travel begins with a choice, right? Should we go or should we stay, right? And that's kind of it's a decision we have to make. But if you are a backseat person, you may not feel like you have a choice. You are going to enter in the spirit of the travel, of the journey, but even though you have a choice, are you going to enter into the spirit of journey or sit with the arms folded and head down and be cranky all the way down wherever you go? So, almost 20 years ago, my family and I came here with a really, we were a family full of fears, but also an excitement to new people, new country, but also facing the unknown. It was a snowy day. We came here on December 2005, and it was a snowy day. Once we cross the border with Texas and then get into Kansas from a 54 highway, it was all snow. And it was 17 hours driving. And I heard very soon a song that lasts all travel along from my kids. Are we there yet? And man, that song can be annoying. Every half hour they were asking, are we there yet? Are we there yet? Finally, we arrived. We started trouble maybe it was early in the morning, like 7, 8 o'clock in the morning from El Paso. And we got to Topeka on that night, 10 o'clock. We arrived to a Walmart parking lot. We didn't know where we were. So I made a phone call. Somebody came and find us and lead us to the parsonage. And the great welcoming was a warming parsonage in the middle of a cold night. And the food pantry was full of food. And we felt like, man, these people really like us and they make us feel welcome. In any journey, in any trouble, there will come times when questions arise. Questions like my kids, are we there yet? Or should we go back? Do we really need or do we really have to take this trip? Our text this morning does not help us with the existential anguish of the world that we live in. So, John the Baptist came to the Jordan River calling out the people with a really hard message. They call these people vipers. They call people sinners. They call them, you have to repent. Man, I wonder if I just go to the street or the main street and I start preaching like John, somebody will call the sheriff and put me in jail because I'm just being rude to the people. At that time, this holy man was calling people, it's time to meet with God. It's time to face a spiritual journey that makes us better, that gets us near to the Lord. And for that, we have to make a decision. We have to choose. Should we go or should we stay? John called people to repent, turn around, and think again. John calls us this morning to think differently about ourselves and our place in this world, in this community, about the one that is coming, and about how are we going to follow him. The journey brings a challenge, but it also brings a reminder of the destination. Do you know what is the hardest decision when you decide to go on a trip? What are you going to put in your suitcase? In your suitcase? We used to travel, me and my wife, with a big suitcases, luggage, really kind of this size. Not anymore, because every plane will allow you just a small suitcase and one backpack or handbag. Nothing else. So we have to challenge ourselves to pack as much as we can in just a small suitcase. And believe me, it's a challenge. What I'm going to, because my wife says, it's because if we're going to a party or a dinner or a formal reunion or with the family or the beach or the picnic, so we have to pack a cloth for every occasion. The challenge was, well, we have to reduce that luggage. And it's not easy, believe me. Okay? So, let me share with you a little bit about our journey. Mary Sol and I met 35 years ago. Do you see that small arrow on the screen on the top? That is the place where we met each other, on Ciudad Juarez, which is border town with El Paso. I was born in Durango. Do you see the lower star? That's the place I was born. That is Durango, Mexico. And the upper star is where my wife was born. And we met on a town very top of the country. And we never thought about going to find each other on there. I was on my first full-time church appointment in 1986. I met her in 1987, for 14th of February, Valentine's Day on 87. We fall in love, we date for 1 year, and then we got married on May 7, 88. Right? I said it right this time? Yes, I said it right this time. So, we were like that time. We were young and handsome and singles and free. And we had to ask ourselves, do we really want to get married? Do you want to live with me the rest of your life? And she says back there, yes. Don't ask her now because she will say, I regret making that decision. 35 years, it's been an adventure. It hasn't been easy. It's been a bumpy road. It's been a up, down, hills. And the road has not been easy. And I'm sure that I'm telling you nothing new this morning to you. But the same thing with our spiritual journey. Sometimes we feel discouraged. Sometimes we feel encouraged to move forward. Sometimes things happen that makes us think, do I am in the right place? I am doing right with my spiritual life. I am guiding my family. I am doing good myself with my faith. So when we moved to USA, it was in 2005, and that was one of the questions we made ourselves. It is the right decision to do, because we have to leave behind family, friends, and the known to embrace the unknown. And that is God. When we love God and we decide to follow him, he will shake us out of our comfort zone. He will take us out and shake a little bit our life and say, you know what? You need to renew yourself. You need to refresh yourself. You need to learn new things. You need start all over again on these areas of your life. Because sometimes we think, well, I'm doing pretty well, but the comfortable things doesn't let us know how well are we doing until we experience new experiences. So, after 34 last May, we accomplished 34 years together. This is our kids. My son, Javier, he is 33. He works for T-Mobile, and he lives in Topeka. Both live in Topeka, and he commutes every day back and forth from Topeka in Kansas City. My daughter, which is Marisol, and she is 31, and she's an attorney and works for the DA on Topeka, and she's going to be married next year, around this time, May, next year. So it's been a really blessing. They are really good kids. But none of them want to be a pastor's or pastor's wife because they said, you move a lot. So we want to settle one time to meet our friends, to grow older with them and enjoy going to McDonald's, drinking coffee, gossiping, and telling old stories. And that's why they just stay in Topeka. Topeka was the time we arrived in 2005. We were invited to do Hispanic ministry back then. And then after a couple times, we went to all the way down to Chicago doing Hispanic ministry. And then in 2005, we came back to J Center, which was our first Anglo church. So since then, we were there for years, then 3 years in Topeka, and now this is a new start, a new beginning for my wife and I. And I have to say thank you. We are grateful because since the first day, we have felt like the community welcomes us. Some people has approached to us in the streets and then just introduce themselves and they just makes us feel welcome, and that's something we really appreciate. So, this is my son's girlfriend. They live together. It's the custom right now, and they don't want to be married. Probably he's wiser than his father. But they don't want to be married for now. Then my daughter and his fiancé, which is Do you know what is the name of my daughter's fiancé? It'd be hard to imagine. His name is Javier. So Javier the father, Javier the son, and Javier the son-in-law. She made it easy. She said, "Could you find another guy with a different name? Just Javier, okay? Just keep it easy." So our journey is not being really easy. Our life together, as you may know probably in your own experience, marriage is something that is not easy. But you have to work it out day by day, right? Sometimes rough days, sometimes really beautiful days. Some mothers, we do not support each other, we do not want to talk to each other. Some others, we're just close and love each other. That's the same thing with the Lord. And He understands how do we feel, how we are. And then He supports the way we try to grow in our faith. But always we have the challenge to review. How are we doing in our marriage? How are we doing in our family life? How are we doing in our faith? I am doing right? Is God pleased with the way I worship, I serve Him, I related with the church? I am doing all what the Lord is asking me to do? I'm really glad to see kids here this morning. And I'm excited to get to know with you guys. But let me tell you, your life will be a challenge if it's not there yet. Back in Yale Center, we were involved in after-school program with the community. And I was invited to teach Spanish. And one of the kids came and said to me, They call me Mr. Mexican. And they said, "Mr. Mexican, my mom says, why in the world I should learn to speak Spanish? I'm never going to be in Mexico." And I said, "You know what? That's the dumbest question you can ask." Because I did. When I was in middle school, my English class, always C plus at the most. And that's the thing I thought. Why in the world I should learn English? I'm never going to be in USA. Here I am. You never know where the life will take you. And you have to be prepared for it, right? So I'm planning, my wife teaching some Spanish classes. You are invited to come. Porque voy a hablar en español y ustedes tienen que responder, right? Because I speak Spanish and then you have to have a conversation with myself, right? Okay, but yeah, the same thing with the spiritual life. You will never know, never you're going to know what the Lord will bring to your life. But we all have to be prepared, okay? If you think my English is awful, you have to see the first guy I met when I spoke English. I started my approach into the English language when I was in Juarez, in El Paso, and with a program, leading a program for my home conference called Volunteers in Mission. My bishop appointed me to be the conference leader for the Volunteers in Mission program. And my job was to meet American groups on El Paso, bring them to Mexico, and stay with them for a week. And they built a house, one room for marginal areas people. So the first group I met at the airport, I get them all, it was about 20, 25 people, I get them all in the school bus who will cross the border with them. I just stood up in front of them and said, "Welcome, now you are my hostage." And they were like, "What, what, what?" I'm your host. And I said, you're my hostage. She's like, what? So, mistakes can be made. This is the picture of my graduation. I was in a training for a week on New York. That's the UN building, and in front of us was the UMW's building on New York. So a friend of mine invites us to come to USA to be developing Hispanic ministry. And we did that for the first 7 years, and then 10 years, and then we moved we went to Chicago for 1 year. We enjoyed having vacations there, but didn't work for us. Weather so hot. If you think heat is hot, well, Chicago is 3 times hot. Snow is worse. The only winter we were there, they told us that was a mild winter. But I have to shovel snow 4 times in the same night just to have a chance in the morning after to walk away from the house. Because if you don't shovel, the snow can be this high or higher. So in front of us used to live a widow, and she instructed me, every single time that you see me going outside to shovel the snow, do the same. And I did, and I'm glad I did. But you know what? By the 4th time, a couple of kids came and knocked on my door, and they said, do you want us to shovel the snow out of the driveway for $25? I give you $30, but just do it. I was tired of 3 times. That person was a really huge two-car garage, so the driveway was really a thing to shovel myself. And my sciatica was complaining by the 3rd time, so yes. That was the time we came on 2005 here. After that, we moved on. That happened on September 2005. And we moved to Topeka on December 19, 2000, same year. Next, please. One thing my wife and I love is dance. We dance every single time we have. But I have to confess, I am a double left foot guy, okay? I thought I was a good dancer, and then my wife says, no, you're not. Her toes can tell you some stories about it. But we try to enjoy. And spiritual life is about dance, about enjoy yourself, about really enjoy the music. And don't think anything else about just being and dancing in the same spirit with your wife. Well, spiritual journey is the same thing. It's just don't think. Just let you go and dancing with the Lord. Enjoy the trip. Enjoy the journey. God will take you to a safe place, and it will be fun if you allow him to take control. Once I allow my wife to take control in dancing, man, I am the best dancer in the hall. Believe me. Sometimes, as we are empty nestor since 2012, we have to learn to dance ourselves in our home. Sometimes she's cooking, and we Mexicans have to play a music for everything. If you're going on a trip, so you have a music for the trip. If you're going to do honey duties, you have a music for the honey duties. And we have a lot of memories with those songs. So we dance when we feel in the mood to dance. Dancing is something that makes us feel full of joy and excitement. I invite you to dance with the Lord. Not just come to the church, not just sing the songs. Enjoy yourselves when you come. See what God has to tell you. See what God is preparing for you every single time you have to come to the church. Sunday morning, maybe, youth group, maybe, Sunday classes maybe, I don't know. But every single time you are here, pay attention and follow God's pace as you dance with Him. Your life will be full of joy. And I think this is the last. I tried to choose the best picture of us. We already have a gray hair. But this is the study of a journey. And we are grateful to have a chance to be in ministry with you. I'll ask you, let us dance together. Let us see what the Lord will bring from us and share with our community. I really long to see these pews, empty pews, full of people who come to worship the Lord. So, I hope you have understand my message. Otherwise, I will repeat it again. It is time for us to be prepared for the Holy Communion. I don't know how Pastor Tony served communion before, but I will set it on my own way, okay? So, tell me your name.
Kelly.
Please, be patient with me. I will get acquainted with your names and faces, okay? But put it on this way. You have just one or two names to learn. But I have a lot to learn. So give the time and patience, okay? Once we bless the elements, I will ask you to just be stand up in the middle of the aisle and walk to us. That's fine? All right? Okay. There will be the ritual on the screens. I will invite you to respond. Christ our Lord invites to his table all who love him and who earnestly repent of their sins and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sins before God and one another. Join me, please. Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with all our heart. We have failed to be an obedient church. We have not done your will. We have broken your law. We have rebelled against your love. We have not loved our neighbors, and we have not heard the cry of the needy. Forgive us, we pray. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples and said, take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples and said, drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant. Put it out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me. And so, in remembrance of these your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, and Christ will come again. Take yours first, Kelly. Please, can you stop and come over? His blood, given for you and for me, for the forgiveness of our sins. This is the blood and body of Christ, given for you, for the forgiveness of our sins. Eat and drink and be grateful. grateful. This is the body of Christ. And this is his blood poured out for you and for me, for the forgiveness of sins. This is the blood of Christ and his body. Give it out for you and for me, for the forgiveness of our sins. This is the blood of Christ and his body.
Amen.
Give it out for you and for me, for the forgiveness of our sins. Eat and drink and be grateful. The blood of Christ and his body. Give it out for you and for me, for the forgiveness of our sins. Drink and eat and be grateful. This is the blood of Christ and his body. Give it out for you and for me, for the forgiveness of our sins. Eat and drink and be grateful. This is the body of Christ and his blood. Give it out in sacrifice for you and for me, for the forgiveness of our sins. Eat and drink and be grateful. This is the body of Christ and his blood. Give it out for you and for me, for the forgiveness of our sins. Eat and drink and be grateful. The body of Christ, his blood. Put it out for you and me, for the forgiveness of our sins. Eat and drink and be grateful. The body of Christ and his blood. Give it out in sacrifice for the forgiveness of our sins. Eat and drink and be grateful. The body of Christ. The blood of Christ. The body of Christ and the blood of Christ. The body of Christ, the blood of Christ. Give it out in sacrifice for the forgiveness of our sins. Eat and drink and be grateful. The body and the blood of Christ. The body and the blood of Christ. The blood and the body of Christ given out for you, for the forgiveness of our sins. Eat and drink and be grateful. The body of Christ and his blood. This is the body of Christ. His blood. Give it out for you and for me, for the forgiveness of our sins. Eat and drink and be grateful. This is the body and the blood of Christ. Give it out for you, for the forgiveness of our sins. Eat and drink and be grateful. The body of Christ and the blood of Christ. Give it out for you and for me, for the forgiveness of our sins. Eat and drink and be grateful. The blood of Christ and the body of Christ. Give it out for you and for me, for the forgiveness of our sins. Eat and drink and be grateful. This is the blood of Christ and his body. Give it out for you and for me, for the forgiveness of our sins. Eat and drink and be grateful. The blood and the body of Christ. Give it out for you and for me, for the forgiveness of our sins. Eat and drink and be grateful. The body and the blood of Christ. Give it out for you and for me, for the forgiveness of our sins. Eat and drink. This is the blood of Christ and his his body, given out for you and for me, for the forgiveness of your sins. Join me in the Lord's Prayer, please. Thank you. Thank you. Join me, please, in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Now, it is time for the happy time in the church. Right? It's a time for the offertory. Is the ushers come forward and help me out, please? You stand, please.
Praise God, praise and flow. Praise the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
I was warned about not seeing this, but the other one. I didn't pay attention to it, sorry, but next time will be much better. Precious God, we present to you this offering. It's a token of love and gratitude for all you have done in our lives. Please receive it. We present it to you with faith and love. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. It is time to go home. Go. And as you go, share Christ's love. Let your light shine and share God's word. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship with the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. It is my understanding the acolytes will come, take the light, and I will follow you. Right? The acolytes still here or they gone? I'll follow you. Let's sing the last song. Hold on. Atia, the three first stanzas and last, okay? Little slower.